Hello children, today we are going to do the derivation of the equations from the graph. Alright, that is through this graphical representation I am going to derive the three equations of motion. Now let us say here the body was moving with a velocity, initial velocity u. Alright, after the time of t seconds, okay, it accelerates and it increases its velocity to v. So let us say here it is v and here it is u. Alright, and how much is the time spent? The time spent is t seconds. Alright, now let us say how I will just name it. Let us say this is A, B, C and D. Okay, now here the slope of this line AB. From the graph, velocity time graph, we know that I can measure acceleration, okay, of the body by measuring the slope of this line AB. So let us take AB. What is the slope? Slope we know is y-axis by x-axis. Now, what is y-axis? Y-axis is this portion, right? So how much is this? This is, if I divide it from here, it is, total is v minus u, right? So for AB, this portion I will take rather, sorry. So BE, so y-axis will be BE by this much, that is the x-axis. So this is AE. Alright, now BE is how much? BE is V minus U and AE is T. And as I said, the slope of this line AB will give me acceleration. So I can write from here that A is equal to V minus U by T, or V minus U is equal to AT, or V is equal to U plus AT. This is the first equation of motion. Alright, now the next one we come to is the displacement. Now from a velocity time graph, how will I find the displacement of the body? I can find it out by finding the area of this figure. Now if you look at the figure carefully, it consists of a right angle triangle and a rectangle. Alright, so if I find out the area of this whole thing, then I can find out my displacement. So let us say, displacement is S is equal to area of the triangle plus area of the rectangle. You can name them according to the figure, like for a triangle it is ABE and for here it is AECD. Right, let us first write the area of the triangle. Now what is the area of the triangle, right angle triangle? It is half base. Now how much is the base? T. Half base into height. And how much is the height? Now see, this is the height of the, this much is the height of the triangle, so I have to take V minus U, okay, plus area of the rectangle is length into breadth, so here it is T into U, or I will just write UT. So let's see how much it comes to. We can say, I'll just reverse it rather, so I'll write it UT plus half T, and instead of V minus U, I will take AT from the first equation. Alright, so it is UT plus half AT square. So here S is equal to, or rather displacement is equal to UT plus half AT square. See, we have now derived the second equation of motion. Alright, I hope you have understood. Now we go on to the third equation of motion, and again this I am going to derive it from the same graph. So this graph is very very important, because from here you can derive all the three equations of motion. Now once again, displacement. as we have said, is the area of this figure. And if you see this figure, it is actually a trapezium, right? Now a trapezium is like, it has two parallel sides, okay, AD and BC. So I will write area of the trapezium, wherein it is the half into sum of parallel sides, sum of the parallel sides into height. Okay, now let's see. Parallel side is this and this. This much is u and this is v into height is this, which is t. Correct? So it is half u plus v, and instead of t, from here I can write v minus u by a. So I have just taken it v, sorry, it's v minus u by a. Now if you look at this, this is v plus u, v minus u. So can I write like this? And this two denominators, I have taken it on the other side. So now it becomes 2as is equal to v square minus u square. Okay, so this is the third formula of motion, that is v square minus u square is equal to 2as. Hope I have made these three questions clear. Thank you.